2 days, 2 big bang economic reform announcements. After announcing a major relief package for the telecom sector on Wednesday, Modi government has taken chasing bad debts to the next level by announcing the bad bank it promised in the budget speech. The biggest bank loan defaulters of India, one-time tycoons like Mehul Choksi, Nirav Modi, Vijay Mallya, among the hundreds others who have managed to dodge repaying their loans. Thanks to them, banks are saddled with bad loans of more than 6 lakh crore rupees. And even taking their cases to the bankruptcy tribunal hasn't really helped banks, where their success rate is just 10% and recoveries less than 40%. Now the Modi government is refocusing its battle against these bad debts through National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, the so-called bad bank. Another institution, the Indian Debt Resolution Company, is also being set up. While the bad bank will absorb big-ticket bad loans from government-owned banks, the IDRC will try and resolve them.
There will now be an asset reconstruction company which will make sure that the managing and disposing of it is done professionally, and which will therefore result in banks' balance sheets and books being cleaner, transparent. They will now be able to stand on their own and do their business.
Initially, around 90,000 crore rupees in bad loans is expected to be transferred to NARCL. Banks in return get 15% of the amount in cash and the rest in security receipts guaranteed by the centre. Banks will also have to pay annual charges on the bad loans transferred. These charges will be increased every year, giving banks an incentive to recover these loans speedily.
There are quite a few asset management companies out there, but when government together with the public sector banks are coming up, it brings in a different dimension because it can now deal with big ticket NPAs.
The bad bank is the latest in a series of banking reforms initiated by the government, which include bank mergers, bringing cooperative banks under the RBI ambit, setting up of bank board bureau, barring willful defaulters from accessing funds from markets, and several fraud preventive measures. The latest measure will enable banks to focus on their core functions, something which the industry will welcome. Bureau Report, Business Today Television.